It was good. It's your boy St. Joe, SoundsGear.com. Want to check out Virtu Instruments Mojo horn section. I've had people ask me for to review a good horn instrument. So this isn't like a bunch of horn loops. This is a contact instrument, so you can actually play the horn. So I'm going to just go through it. Basically, this is the interface right here. You got your instruments and you got multis. Your instruments are core instruments, core instrument light, ensembles, riffs, special effects, sustains, and then if you have a wind controller, they got instruments specifically made for using with the MIDI wind controller. The core instruments have all the articulations, all the different up, down, runs, duets, sustains, everything like that. Then the light versions have the same articulations as the core instruments, but they just load less samples, so it saves on your resources. Ensembles, as you can see, they're made up of different ensembles of the different instruments. Riffs, they got a gang of riffs in here spread across the keys, so you also get some riffs to play with. And they got special effects in there, and then your sustains are just the sustain sounds. So instead of loading all the articulations, you just want to load one of the single instruments. It's a sustain. The instruments that come in it are the alto sax, the bari sax, the bass trombone, clarinet, flugelhorn, flugelhorn, whatever you say it, piccolo, trumpet, soprano, sax, tenor sax, trombone, a muted trombone, another trombone, the regular trombone, then you got a cup muted trumpet, and then a regular trumpet. Those are all the sounds, all the instruments that come in it, and then you got all the different variations of sustains and articulations and everything. So right now I got the alto sax, the core instrument loaded up, so it has all the different articulations. Right here you can adjust the amount of players, so it goes from from solo to up to like 10 players. You can adjust it from polyphonic to mono to legato. You can also go into the setup if you wanted to and mess with all the different vibrato settings or the section settings, how many players you want to, you know, default to when you change the section, your pitch bends, your releases. You can pretty much edit everything, your micro tuning, legato. You can edit everything in there. And this shows you your active articulation. This shows you what release is active. You also got effects. So you can go into the effects. You can go into the easy room if you want to get a quick reverb setting. There's all the different settings right there. And you also, of course, got your equalizer you can mess with, activate it or not. You got your compressor that you can activate, saturation, distortion, chorus, reverb, delay, of course, stereo imaging, and then your limiter. So you can turn those on or off and do whatever you want. Then right here you can set up the key switches, see what note they respond to, and or if you want to learn it to your MIDI controller or whatever. And that's basically the setup. So I'm gonna just start playing some of this stuff. So here's just the basic, you see sustain, vibrato. You can go over here and change to, like, you see it's the subtones. Got your pow. Let's see what else you got. Your overblown vibrato. Of course, all this is key switchable, so you can switch it as you're playing. Overblown. You do it. Here, and then that one. Got your run up octaves. You got another dual. You got your crescendo. It's a long crescendo. Here's your swell, long swell. You got a short swell. Then your vibrato back over there. Of course, you got sustains in there. Your regular sustain. Your sustained vibrato. So the quality is pretty good. Definitely the best horn instruments I've heard personally. I love them. They sound real realistic and they're fun to play. So say that's a solo player. Let's go up to two. Say we want to add four players. It automatically spreads around the stereo field. There's six players. 8 players. And then you got 10 players. So let's check out, let's go into some of the ensembles. Let's check out one of these ensembles over here. See what that sounds like. So that's an alto sax and a tenor sax together. I'll let it load up. Some of the instruments are pretty big, some of them are not. So it just depends on which one you're playing with. The core instruments are the biggest ones. There's that type of ensemble. Here's an alto sax, trumpet, and a trombone ensemble. So these are pretty good if you want to get a nice mixture of a horn type section real quick without making your own multis. They already got them overlapped, and they overlap in specific areas. So they may not overlap on every key, just specific ones to make it sound more realistic. Of course, they respond to your velocity and everything. Let's check out this trumpet, another section real quick. I'm going to show you as many of the different types of sounds as I can in my short amount of time that I got you here. So you got a trumpet, alto sax, and tenor sax. Alright, you got that. Let's check out some of the riffs. So here you got, let's see, it says, tells you what key it's in and what BPM. These are pretty quick loading because they're not too many samples in there. It just depends on which one you get. But that's a bunch of riffs you can go in and play with. You got some pretty authentic riffs, and as you can see, I got all the different instruments have their own riffs and tempos and everything like that. Some of the special effects are pretty cool. Those load pretty quick as well. So, you know, some pretty cool stuff in there, definitely. You can see all the different, so it's all your same basic instruments, but they're just different. You got those in there, and you got your sustain onlys, which is, it's basically like just playing the instrument by itself, no special articulations. So if you just want to load up a single trumpet or a clarinet or whatever and play it, this would probably be the one to load up out of the sustain only ones. So you don't, it doesn't take up as much RAM and memory, and it doesn't have all the articulations in there, but it's still, you know. You can see you got them all in there. There's a clarinet over there. Let's load that up. So, I mean, this is definitely a very, very, very fun library to play with. I've been playing with it ever since I sent it over. I think I got it earlier this week. I've been playing with it. I just like playing with it because it sounds so realistic. It's a nice little clarinet. It just sounds good to me, personally. So let's load up a muted trumpet. The trombone. Let's do the trombone. Like I said, the realism of these samples, if you like horns, saxophones, you know, trumpets and stuff like that, these aren't really orchestral brass. This is more of a brass section, like jazz, funk, R&B type stuff. But if you like those type of sounds, this is hands down the best one to check out. I haven't come across a horn instrument that sounded this realistic. Definitely, man. You see everything you get in there. Wind controller, if you got that. Sustain, special effects, a bunch of riffs that you can play with as well. Play across the keys. Different ensembles already set up. Core instruments, light and regular core instruments, which load all the articulations at once. And then, of course, you got multis that they already set up for you. So, yeah, man. It's your boy, St. Joe, SoundsOfGear.com. Checking out Bird 2 Instruments Horn Section. Mojo. Check it out.